Excel Charts, Chapter 4, Pie Slices Galore. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelling. Well, you know, a lot of pie charts that you see, they're real nice. They have 3, 4, 5 slices and everything works out great. But in real life, you know, there's some products that are high flyers, other products that, you know, they're backlist, they're old, we still keep them around, they sell a few, but not enough. And so here's a pie chart. 4 items really matter. The rest of the stuff is just, you know, tiny little things that no one can really make a lot of sense out of. So I'm going to change this chart type. There's 6 different pie charts to choose from, and I'm interested here in either something called the pie of pie or the bar of pie. And I'll choose bar of pie in this particular case. Choose OK. And you see what happens is the Excel decides to keep some of the slices in the major pie and then move other slices out to the secondary axis. Now, I'm not sure what the default is here, but I never like it. So I'm going to right-click and choose Format. And we get to control how to split this. Do we split it by position, or do we split it by value or percentage value? All right, so I'm going to split it by value and say that the second plot should contain values less than, let's say, 1,000. And we'll click OK to take a look at that. Click close. Okay, so now we have 4 major items in the pie, and then the all other is all of the items less than 1,000. Now you have to decide in your data set what makes the most sense. And then the next thing is, are we really interested in the 4 items or are we interested in the other? We have a few settings here. So again, I'm going to go back into Format Data Series, and we'll take a look at this pie explosion, gap width, and secondary plot size. All right, so we can go to a really small secondary plot size compared to the pie, and then it's hardly visible at all. Or sometimes you might be interested in those all other items, and so we can make that even larger than the primary pie so we can see the detail. Your call as far as what you want to do there. You also can control the gap, the amount of gap between the pies, and also whether they are together or separate. Now watch out for this pie explosion setting. It is not 0. It's always resets to 0. This is a bug in this dialog box. So if I set that to 76, when I come back in later, it is going to pick up. Well, hey, there you have it. Cool way to take all those small slices that are crowded out to secondary. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another Netcast from Mr. Excel.